Welcome to our April Supervisors meeting. I'll call the meeting to order and invite you to join the board as we stand and pledge the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, at this time, Mike Reinhardt is going to fill in for Carol, and would you do the roll call?
Certainly. Roll call, Jerry Long.
Present.
Arthur Zerbe.
Here.
Melvin Boyd.
Here.
Bill Cassidy.
Here.
And Mike Reinhardt is engineer slash secretary for tonight.
Okay, at this time, we have an open community session, and I limit it to 4 minutes each person. If we have time after everyone had their opportunity, we can give you a second try. Obviously, you can bring concerns to the township office at any time, and if you think you need more than 4 minutes sometime, you can schedule and be put on the agenda. So at this time, we'll open the floor up, and anyone want to go first? Cindy, go.
Yeah, I guess I'm curious. I'm not seeing anything necessarily on the agenda about the hearing yesterday about the rezoning issue in terms of township land, Rule 6.5. So maybe perhaps we'll hear some more about whatever transpired in yesterday's meeting and down that line just there. Once again, I just want to have put on the official record the fact that we are a village. My understanding is that the people down the line here are not amenable to us changing our zoning. I continue to be concerned about the two different versions of zoning changes. I appreciate Bill showing me the code last time I was here, as opposed to telling me to go to the website. However, again, I have yet to hear anybody answer my initial question going back months ago. What kind of research has gone into who might be interested in putting a property or business or whatever happens to be along these different areas? The variety of businesses that can be put out there is myriad, some of which would certainly be fine for a place like Millsville. Some I don't think any of us would like to see in Millsville, so that concerns me. It seems to me if you want to have some sort of controlled development, there should have been some kind of contact with realtors, et cetera, to say, hey, what is out there, what is happening, who's kind of trolled around, look, maybe it's of interest. My other concern is some of the properties are not on a major highway, i.e. in our case, 6.5. So it seems to be a moot point from those pieces. Again, I'm just concerned about the lack of real study and research about this whole thing. I understand one or two people saying this may bring in money to the township. It may or may not. When you talk about bringing in money, you talk about jobs. And again, I think the number of jobs going to Lancaster was not quite accurate when we reported versus what they came back with. And again, our infrastructure is not, you know, we can come to these meetings time after time, whether it's a sewer commission meeting, whatever it happens to be, and we know that our infrastructure is limited. And in many cases, it is old. So therefore, it would seem that how can you just open it up to any kind of development that fits under those two categories, knowing that the infrastructure is not there, knowing that possible jobs may not be there, and having no clue who or what may come into the township. Those of us that live here for a reason, a certain lifestyle. We are not a city, we are a village. There is a reason we are a village. We are a bedroom community, whether people want to admit that or not, we are. Many of us travel long distances every week, every day, to get to and from work. Not everyone has been born and raised and worked in Wilmington. So I am just concerned because I don't see any real planning in terms of what this could entail should these changes be made. And I am concerned, continue to be concerned since day one.
Okay, thank you. Anyone else?
Welcome.
State your name just for the record.
Okay, my name is Dave Fisher. I'm president of Pipewood Landmills. I'm also the UMD with Pipewood Landmills. I'm a resident of the area. I'm not a resident of Brecknock Township, but I spent a lot of time going to Boston to Brecknock Township. And I'd like to thank the board for giving me the opportunity to speak to you tonight. I'd like to thank you for your support to the Landmills over the past, you know, decades. I've been a president, I guess, for 3 years, and I don't want to come to a meeting I've ever been here. And the concern came up recently, and not just this past weekend, because we're going to log on to the thing on a certain day. Our concern is it's taking the state police longer and longer and longer to get here. And every time we go on a call, we have to make a decision as to whether it's safe for our crews to go into the scene or not into the scene. If it's not safe, then we need to sit and wait for the state police to get there. Sometimes we're waiting 30, 40, 50 minutes. If it's something that we need to respond to, then we need to make a decision, can the patient wait that long for us to get there, or can they not wait that long? It's putting us in a position, we're doing really well at trying to analyze what's going on, can we go safely, can we not go safely, should we wait, shouldn't we wait? But lately, it's becoming longer and longer and longer, and to the point that I was actually refusing to respond to this past weekend for an incident that I really needed to have. So I just encourage the board, look at your opportunities, or look at what you have around you. Is there something else you can do? Can you get us police services maybe a little bit quicker? Do you need a police officer in the township 24 hours a day? Probably not. I understand it's a costly venture. I've had one for 28 years. And there's a lot of things for you guys to think about. I just encourage you in the future to just look, see if there's something maybe you can work on the side maybe to get us over here. Or get there quicker at least if that can happen. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, I know that you serve, you just don't serve in Brecknock Township. You carry over into Terry Hill and actually into East Earl.
Actually, yeah, we do.
And do you see a big difference in response time outside of Brecknock Township?
We get a police officer on almost every incident, whether we need them or not, in anything in East Earl or Terry Hill Borough. Rural Township, we have pretty much a police officer on every incident. Those departments, local police departments, are pretty much encouraged, if not required, to go to every incident just to make sure it's okay. They may not help us, they may not stay very long. And that's all based on their priority of where they're busy, what's going on. If they have something more important to be at, they'll be at that. They won't come to our ambulance calls. But this is a huge thing.
There is a
usually
difference.
The police are there before we get there. Everywhere else except for Brecknock Township or Carnarvon Township, which is also covered by state.
Well, we're aware of it now, and I thank you for coming out and reminding us, because unless someone's feeding us, giving us feedback, we're not aware of the day-to-day things. It is a concern of ours, and we hear it more and more, and we need to take steps that we can actually arrive at some point to having better protection.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Anyone else like to speak? Okay, that will conclude our community time. And we move on to the minutes. You have the minutes in your packet. Are there any corrections or additions to the minutes as they're presented?
I'll make a motion that we accept the minutes as written.
I second it.
Okay, we had a motion to accept the minutes as they are, and it was second. Those in favor say aye.
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 Motion carries. Now you have the bills in front of you, and I did total them if you haven't. Total is $57,229.78. Have you just looked at the bills and find them? Okay.
I make a motion that we pay the bills in that amount, $57,229.78.
I second.
Okay, we had the motion to pay the bills. And it was second. Those in favor say aye.
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 Motion carries. Okay, we have the reports. We have the roadmaster's report. Do you have anything you want to add beyond what you gave?
I don't think so. The bid tally bids that came in this morning, they were a low bidder, did come in close to actually 40,000, less than what I had estimated, so
very good.
Good. And also the Todd bids, they also a couple thousand less than what I had estimated, so I was really pleased with how all the numbers came in.
Excellent. Excellent.
How's that bid calculated? By the yard, or do you know?
I didn't get a detailed look at the bids, but I believe they're by the square yardage for the base repair.
I was with Chuck Kiefer, you know Chuck, Brecknock Township Roadmaster, Brooks County. And he told me he was at one of the meetings. And he said, there's no way you can tell what you're getting from them, from these firms, when they bid them by the yard.
Are we referring to, just out of curiosity, are we referring to the oil and chip? Or
yeah.
The oil and chip, okay.
He says, the only way you can calculate it close, and he's been a roadmaster a long time, is you have to calculate the footage into the tonnage that they actually use. But per yard, you could be cheated awful bad. Yeah, the yards they say they covered.
Right, and I know the formula on what, how to get the the gallons. They generally use, I think it's 0.35 gallons per square yard, and I think it's 22 pounds of stone per square yard. So I can figure, I know how to figure that out, that, you know, if I see their slips and see what tonnage they use, and if it's way off, you know, then I know it wasn't done right, and that, you know, that's what it's supposed to be put down as, and if they don't, they can easily get caught very easily.
Now, Chuck, he really paid attention. His stick's pretty good. But I told him, I've seen roads where it didn't last a year. He looked at me, he says, Arthur, I know a road didn't last 1 week. That's how then they put it on, you know.
Well, in that case, the contractor would have to come back and reapply
right.
it.
That was obviously illegal. Illegal what they did, yeah.
Well, just keep an eye on it.
Yeah.
Try to figure it out. It's not easy. It's more complicated, I think.
But they do give you slips for each load, right? Or is it each day you get the slips for what the
each client? Day they come down and give us the slips. If I was out there all day with them, they would give me slips.
Okay. Okay.
But I don't have the time to sit out there and babysit them all day. I mean, but yeah, it's, you know, if it's not put down right, it's very, you know, you can cash it, so. I know through the COG, I know they contemplate that every year, bidding it by the tons versus the square yardage, and I'm not sure if it's not pending out approved to do by the tonnage or something, or if the contractors have issue with it being by the tonnage. I'm not sure what the dispute is there. I haven't been in it long enough to find that out, but they do talk about that every year. And they've been opting to go the square yardage way, but I think someday I think it will change and they will do it by the tonnage.
Well, it is important. It is taxpayers' money being spent. So, you know, try to make as much effort as you can to get out there, and either you or Levi occasionally just don't let a whole day go by. And
oh, no. I try to make it a point when they're out there doing work. I just swing in every few hours, usually, and depending on what's going on. There was a point last year I actually rode on the chipper with them for a little bit. But they're not, they don't know when I'm coming, so kind of keeps them on my toes, on their toes. If I'm not there, they don't know when I'm going to show up. And they have been, I've been forcing them, well, it's required, but I've been getting the oil samples also when they do the oil and chip, and we get an oil sample from each tanker.
Anything else?
No.
Okay, the engineer report?
Okay, I have a copy of my report of April 6th. On page number 4, at the bottom, you'll see there's only one item listed on this report. Having said that, I had about 4 phone calls on Friday and Monday for folks looking for financial security releases and so forth, receiving information. So I'm going to update that for you just verbally tonight. Item one is the Levi Line Box Stormwater Management Project. That's a financial security release in the amount of $1,843.36. In addition to that, tonight, I did receive a memorandum of understanding for Espenshade's Greenhouse. That's for a pre-application meeting with Mr. Espenshade regarding a subdivision plan. In addition to that, item number three would be the Summit Tower Project, the cell tower. We received today by Federal Express the stormwater management agreement for that project. I do have those here tonight. Bill, I didn't know if you, I know we received some email correspondence and have the hard copies here tonight.
I received that.
Also, in addition, item number four would be the Earl and Alice Martin subdivision. You have a copy of that in front of you tonight, dated April 11. That's a financial security release in the amount of $2,160.11. Item number five would be the John David Hoover Stormwater Project. That is a project that he installed a greenhouse on his property, and subsequently he's selling the property to someone else and has since removed the greenhouse, which we confirmed that removal has happened over the weekend. It is gone. So we have a financial security release in the amount of $200 in our letter of April 11th on your table this evening. And the last item would be the Robert Zimmerman project. That's on 472 Gaiman School Road. That's a memorandum of understanding for a stormwater project and also a letter to recommend establishing the financial security in the amount of $2,750 for that project.
Okay, we have any questions on the six items that Mike has recommended action? If not, I'll make a motion that we approve the six items as recommended by Township Engineer.
I'll second it.
And it was second. Those in favor say aye.
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 Motion carries.
Thank you.
Okay, you have the zoning SEO report, and you have the zoning officer's report. Okay, you have a letter from our zoning officer concerning the Philip Lice violation. Do you want to summarize this for us, Levi?
I think the letter pretty well summarizes that there's been an attempt made to get voluntary compliance over the last 11 months now, and this hasn't happened. So he's made headway, but it's not as far from cleaned up.
What generally is his response? Is he
the last a willingness to do it and a commitment, a verbal commitment to do it. The last date, when he asked for an extension, I had him set the date. So it was not a date that I set for him, but he himself set for him and said that he had a commitment to it and waited for small stakeholders.
And you brought that to the board last week, last month. Yeah, I remember.
Well, I think actually it was in February. Yeah,
because
I was out of town in March.
Okay. What is the nature of the items he's storing there? Is it something he's using in his business or his hobby or what?
Well, he's collecting junk, metal junk, and there's also some other junk in bags alongside the garage.
Well, I'd like to give him every opportunity to clean it up. We'd rather have compliance than fines, but...
My impression was that 11 months is given pretty much every
I agree with that.
Mr. Cassidy, what is the next step that the board can take if they desire?
Well, Levi and I reviewed this a while ago. Several months ago now, and I think there were three particular ordinances that we could use to cite him. I will have to refresh my recollection regarding it.
But there were three that we could use to cite him. Each one have the capability of fines. I think your alternatives are to give him more time. Two, I could send him a letter saying if you don't get it done within X number of days, you know, under my letterhead, you know, the township will consider taking legal action. Or you could go right to authorizing the issuance of, you know, notice of violations to proceed under the ordinances. I don't remember what they were. I think one was the zoning ordinance, one was the junk ordinance, and there was a third, and I don't recall off the top of my head what the other ordinance was.
I think it was being a dealer. I'm not.
Yeah, that does ring a bell, but.
I wasn't passed lately. According to your picture, it looked like he cleaned up half of it.
I would say it's probably half in that entranceway to the garage, but there's a lot of stuff alongside the garage, which.
Is there much?
Yeah.
Okay. Is there much stuff out back on the lot? The lot continues on the Lost Town Road.
I don't know. At this point, I don't know. Earlier, when I checked it, there was nothing.
Well, I guess I wouldn't mind if Bill would send him a letter, or it's just more of a, we're going to meet business shortly if he doesn't comply, and see if that can trigger something. I know over the winter, the weather and the short days and stuff, but now that it's, you know, we're getting to spring, and he certainly should be able to work at it. I mean, ultimately, we'd like compliance. Willingly.
Where does he get this stuff?
I don't know where he got it.
What's he doing with the acetylene and oxygen tanks sitting out there?
I don't know if he's cutting it up.
Yes,
or not. I don't know.
He has more than one set sitting there.
It could well be, yes.
I think we've been patient long enough. You said 11 months?
Yeah.
I know when you came in.
May 2nd or May 5th.
When you came in.
When I first sent the first letter.
When you came in February, we agreed to give him another 30 days. I disagreed. I think we've waited long enough. I think you agree with that, yes.
It's, the pleasure of the board is what
the next step. Do you know this guy, Melvin?
No, sir.
Do you know this guy? Mm-hmm. Would you be willing to personally go out and.
Well.
I mean, I wish maybe some one of us would contact him personally and see if.
I can. Although it was just hard to deal with the whole family.
Oh.
You know.
Would you want me? I can do it. Mm. I don't know the family.
They had the store involved.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I remember that. Yep.
I mean, I don't think he'd get violent. No.
He'll even
talk nice to you.
He's been respectful.
Yeah.
Yeah. He understands.
His mother was a supervisor. Mm-hmm. You know, so.
So, Bill, explain a little bit what the next step would be. I mean, we're talking about citing for a violation and a fine. What actually?
Well, the dealer idea that you mentioned, I think, is under the zoning ordinance. So he was conducting a business, you know, dealing in junk, as I recall.
Can you print the letter that
I sent to you? With the zoning ordinance, Levi did send a notice of violation already, and you could go to the district justice and cite him, you know, for violating the ordinance. The other two ordinances, the junkyard ordinance, and I forget the third one, also provide, as I recall,
a summary offense that, you know, a civil citation would be issued and filed with the local district justice, and they all would allow for the district justice to impose a particular fine.
Is that what we're talking about now, or are we talking about that after a letter citing him for actual?
Well, I'd have to take a look and see. I remember that the, I think Levi's letter referenced all three ordinances. So, assuming that the time limitations have expired, you could proceed under all three.
To do what?
To go file with the district justice.
And file a fine?
A civil citation, which would result, offense.
Result in a fine?
Yep. For violating the zoning ordinance on the other two respective ordinances.
And then how does that work? Does he get so many days at that point?
Well, he gets served by the district justice's office, and then the hearing is scheduled. He has an opportunity to attend and raise any defenses that he thinks he has to the citations. The district justice would make a decision, you know, whether to uphold the request for, you know, the imposition of a fine or not. I believe under the zoning ordinance, the maximum fine is up to $1,000. Now, oftentimes the district justices don't start at $1,000. You know, for a first time that someone is issued a citation from the zoning officer, he might start at a lower amount. The district justice might start at, you know, $100, $200, and if he comes back in with multiple offenses, he could increase it to get his attention. Or he could start at a larger amount, given the length of time here that has passed. So,
but we both pay for it. The township will pay, and he will pay.
You want to try to talk to him?
Yeah, I don't want to not support Levi, but I just wish that maybe one of us would go out and talk to him and say, look, this is going to change, or we will. Give him that one last chance.
What if we do this? Today's the 11th. If you can see him till the weekend, tell him he has 2 weeks, virtually 2 weeks till the end of the month. He doesn't show improvements and show them fast, there's going to be papers filed with the district magistrate.
Well, he did show some improvement, didn't he, Levi?
He's on it.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it's only half the stuff it was before.
I'm okay with that.
Well, if he shows some more improvement, that still doesn't take care of the problem.
But we're getting closer.
We just go out with trucks and help him.
That would give him 2 weeks. Okay, I'll go along with that.
Does the board agree? Do we send him the final letter, or do we just send it to the district magistrate
at
the end of the month before the next township meeting?
I'll go visit. Yeah. Bill. The question.
I'm sorry, Art.
Well, now the board has to decide. Jerry's going to visit with him and give him till the end of the month to show more compliance. At that point, Jerry can. Now, does the board want to go with a final letter from you? This is it? Or do we just hand it over to the district magistrate at the end of the month?
We're
going to
be
the
one.
Yeah, right. That's what the board's decision here.
Yeah.
Before we make a decision, I'm going to ask Levi a question. Levi, can you hear me? Piled up alongside this garage, I see these bags.
That looks like garbage.
If this is garbage, that says rats infestation.
Probably not if it was just put there this winter.
No.
I think.
Why doesn't he have a trash man?
Well, I'll find it out.
And if it is trash, It's just a matter of loading it on a trailer and taking it to the landfill.
What is in these bags here?
I don't know what it is. He said it's that other individuals brought it there and he accepted it. I have no idea why.
What? Taking my garbage there.
Maybe you can move it.
Okay, that's one. This is, that's another one.
This is a junkyard. The nuisance.
And then this was a follow-up letter after our February meeting, just to, I talked to him on the phone. I told him I'm going to write him a letter, just this.
When's he normally around?
Late afternoon, yeah. Yep.
Back to your question, Arthur. I would think maybe we would just have it at the end, in 2 weeks, have, if he doesn't make any improvement, we'll have Bill Cassidy send in the letter.
I think we need to find out what's in these bags.
Well, it doesn't matter what's in them, he has to get rid of them.
Yeah, that's my opinion.
You know. I agree 100%, but when you say some improvement, if these bags are full of trash.
I told him the bags are included.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that last letter, if that, this one, I need to speak this again. Even the three ordinances, the zoning violation, or the violation notices that included three ordinances wouldn't just limit it to the front of the property. It would be all-encompassing.
And Bill, you're saying the fines could be up to $1,000?
Well, on the one ordinance, the...
Is this a upfront fine, or is this so much a day that it's left that way?
Well, depending on the language of each ordinance, the one ordinance, the OIC, each day is a separate violation, separate offense.
Which one is that?
That is the junkyard. Same with the zoning. The zoning is a separate violation for each day. The zoning is up to $500 a day. The junkyard is up to $600. The junkyard and the nuisance is up to 1,000.
Do you think anyone's living in the garage? There's an air conditioner through the window in the garage.
I'm not aware of anybody living there.
That's a detached, is that not a detached building?
Well, I had to read what it is.
Okay.
But having an air conditioner in the garage, you have an air conditioner in your room?
No, I don't. But I can understand.
Okay.
Where we lived before, it got hot as places in there. But I never worked in there. I don't know if he does or not.
Are we okay with just after 2 weeks, if nothing's done, Bill, we'll send him a letter and then we'll finalize it at our next month's meeting?
That will have to be
okay.
It.
So we're gonna give him an additional 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And then it's not cleaned up while you're
inspecting
it.
Yeah.
I would suggest a written letter giving him this additional 2 weeks instead of just a verbal. So we have it in the record.
This is my recommendation that we have Mr. Cassidy send him a letter. That's in 2 weeks.
Oh, in 2 weeks.
No.
Now and then in 2 weeks if he doesn't. Okay.
All right.
I'm okay with that.
The letters from the township haven't been very effective.
Does that have to be a motion or can that just be a...
I have a motion for that.
Okay. Someone make that a motion?
I'll make that motion.
Second.
I'll second it.
Okay, we had the motion that Bill would send him a letter immediately, give him 2 weeks, and at which point, if there's, it's not totally cleaned up, or at least satisfactorily, then you will take action.
You say 2 weeks, you mean the end of this month?
The end of the last day of this month. Yes, yes.
All right, okay, just to be clear on that.
Okay, we had the motion, is there a second?
Second.
Okay, the motion was made in second, those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Bill, do you have any report?
I like, the question I have, Mike, is back on the Summit Tower, they submitted a bond for the financial security.
Yes.
I think at a previous meeting, the amount was approved.
The amount was approved, yes. It was recommended for approval, and it was approved.
That's fine.
Yep.
Correct.
Okay, do we have a motion to approve the reports?
I make a motion that we approve the roadmaster, engineer, SEO zoning, and solicitor as presented.
I'll second that motion.
Okay, the motion was made to approve the reports, and it was second, those in favor say aye. Aye.
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Okay, you have your Brecknock Township, I mean the Park and Rec minutes. Anything you want to discuss with that?
Trail camps.
I haven't had a chance to purchase any yet.
Okay, before we go on to old business, I see Cindy's back. You left, so we did not respond to your comments, and I'll just try to brief a little bit. The reason there's nothing on the agenda on the rezoning, because it was, we submitted to the county for their review and comments. That will go back to our planning commission, so it's really outside of our taking any type of action or engaging in action on it. The planning commission should have the comment review letter from the county for this month's meeting. And some of the things you're bringing up are kind of the stuff that was already discussed and talked, and maybe should be more in, discussed with the planning commission. They're the agency that's behind the planning process, and until they give the board their final recommendations, it's probably premature for us to be doing a lot of discussion on it. So as far as, you know, some of the reason they're reviewing this is because we've asked them back in June, because the highway commercial was totally built out. So sometimes townships are forced to expand that area and may not necessarily have a demand or you know, someone actually interested in purchasing it, but there should be something available that if someone does, and I know, I'll just share that the highway commercial had about, I think it was 17 uses that were only permitted in the highway commercial. So when that became built out, literally those uses were no longer had any place to be permitted in our township. I think 15 of them were permitted by right, and then one was a special exception, one was a conditional use. So, and for instance, I know one was a car wash, one was small lawn and garden equipment repair, so there were some items that potentially, if the residents in our township was looking for a place to do that kind of stuff, we had absolutely zero permitted areas available. And so that's, again, that's all back to the Planning Commission, and we'll look for their final comments and recommendations for our next meeting.
Do you mean our local Planning Commission?
Yes, yes.
Well, the reason I made my comment is because the issue first came up with this group. So
that's fine. This group gave the assignment to our planning commission to evaluate and make the recommendations, and then we forward their recommendations to the county for their comments. So some of this discussion on the actual planning and implementation and how it was come up really took place at that level, and they started that, you know, they've been at that for a couple months, and they had input from the county, and that's that's how they reached that decision.
Now, of course, this is going to be the May hearing.
Yeah. Okay, on to old business. You have the a copy of the bid that in the, that went out, and I guess we received them today.
This is for Bevins over at Mackery?
Yeah, this is.
Now, we have other things that are going to be done besides these three things, right?
Yes. That is separate from the COG stuff that I'm doing.
Okay, very good.
Yeah, we will have to make a motion on it. You're actually going to be awarding both, or considering awarding both. So this would be, if you want to start with the ones we received today, which would be the base repair and East Black Creek Road and so forth, we can do that, and then the COG. They actually require us, now that they've awarded the COG bids, each individual municipality also must award their portion of the work that they're looking at doing for the oil and ship or the rug fill that's involved. So that would be a separate item.
But my understanding, alternate one was both roads, then alternate two and alternate three broke them individually.
That's correct. Carol and Andy, we all discussed that as looking for prices in the event that alternate one, both prices may be too large for your budget. So we did want to also look at both projects separately in the event that there would not be enough money, for whatever reason, the cost would exceed the budgetary constraints that we have. But as Andy noted earlier, obviously, alternate one is both projects. And we would be able to handle, that's $40,000, I believe you said. It was less than your estimate.
So you only had the bid opening today?
At 11 o'clock.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Did you have enough time to review it and feel comfortable making a recommendation?
I did not review it, but yeah, I mean, I recommend that we do both.
Okay.
Rubacher Excavating got the low bid, so I would recommend that we, give it to them.
In my role, Jerry, I did the bid opening, and Andy looked at the prices and so forth. They were required to provide a bid bond. They also had to provide PennDOT pre-qualification certification and anti-collusion affidavit, workman's comp, so forth. And from my review, they have provided all of those items. I'll give the package over to Bill. Usually he takes another look at it to make sure everything's in order. However, it looked like everything was in order from what I saw.
So this alternate one, Rubacher is the low bidder there.
They're the apparent low bidder.
And that's Rubacher Excavating. That's both projects. That's both streets. That's right. A combination of both two and three.
Overlaid this year from Malsley Road out to the township line. And then East Black Creek Road would have base repair done from 625 all the way to Lower Road.
So alternate one would includes two and three.
Right.
I got you.
Yeah.
That makes sense. Yes. Do we need to make a motion to accept this?
Yes, you do.
Are we ready to make that motion, or is there more discussion on it?
I guess that it does include the prevailing wage.
Yes.
Yeah.
It was specified in the contract, in all the contract documents.
Just wanted to make sure that it would change it dramatically.
Yep, that was absolutely.
Well, it sure would make a difference.
Yeah, I did see that. Yeah.
Yeah, the amount exceeded the prevailing wage rate, so they had to provide that.
And you said it's actually $40,000 better than you.
It's $40,000 less. I had.
What you estimate for our budget?
Yeah. I don't know the exact numbers, but I had budgeted $230,000
or something. It's roughly around in there for this. And Rubacher came in at $188,062.35.
I'll make a motion. We
accept this bid. Rubacher Excavating, the amount of $188,062.35. I second it. Okay, we had the motion to accept alternate one to Rubacher Excavating, as stated, and it was second. Those in favor say aye.
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 Motion carries. Do you know this company?
Yeah, I, to be honest with you, I have never worked with them.
Okay, do we have to do any action on the cog stuff?
Yes. You would have, I believe, under the roadmaster's report, is that under your report, Andy?
Yeah, I gave him the final numbers.
Final numbers for that. The apparent low bidder for the seal coat was Stewart and Tate at 91.5 cents per square yard. I believe most of the, bulk of the projects considered a single application of seal coat. And then the rut fill, the low bidder, Andy, correct me if I'm wrong, Asphalt Maintenance Solutions?
That's correct, yes.
At $176 per ton. If I'm missing something, slurry yet?
Yeah, asphalt.
That was also Asphalt Maintenance Solutions for the slurry seal.
Microsurf slurry, there we go. On top of oil and chip and the Cedar Street, Oakleaf Court, and Floodside Drive. And then, what, the line painting?
Mid-Atlantic Marking.
Yeah, Mid-Atlantic Marking got the line painting, I don't have any exact.
Yeah, they're at 48 cents per linear foot for single yellow and single white, and nine and a third cents for double yellow.
I had estimated this to be at $141,950.50 total cog bid, and it's coming in at $137,093.08.
4,000 less, roughly.
But the only applications you're doing here is the rut and fill, the single chip seal coat, and the slurry seal.
And the line painting.
And the lines, you're not doing any double eight or any double four?
No, ultra thin, no.
Okay.
So the board's consideration, the next step would be to award those projects to those individual contractors, and then I would proceed with a contract that they would sign, and then provide back to the township.
Well, I can make a motion that we award the slurry seal to Asphalt Maintenance Solutions, the rut and fill and single to Stewart and Tate. No, the rut fill is also Asphalt Maintenance Solutions. So that's this slurry fill and rut fill to Asphalt Maintenance, and then the chip seal coat, single coat to Stewart and Tate, and the line paintings to Mid-Atlantic Marking.
I'll second that.
Okay, we had the motion. Was second. Those in favor say aye.
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 Motion carries. Okay, we have under new business, we have an application for the park and rec, and we saw this last month. And since then, I did make a phone call and talk to Amanda. She grew up in Reinholds. Attended Calico High School. She went to Albright College, and she's very interested in helping, and the Park and Rec Board did recommend that she be allowed to serve on the committee, so I can support this if there's a motion for such.
I'll make that motion. I'll accept this application from Amanda Marshall.
I
serve on the Park and Rec.
Okay, we had the motion to appoint her to the Park and Rec. I was second. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Motion carries. Does that conclude our required action for tonight? Is there a motion to adjourn?
The motion that we adjourn at, I don't know what time.
8:40.
7:48.
Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Okay. The motion was made and second to adjourn. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. The motion carries.